Serenity Now, right, John? Yeah, Serenity Now. We're going to be explaining this stuff shortly, but Billy Joel is back. Yes, indeed. And so we are here with the thought and feeling. Look at this cat. Whoa, for the longest time. Whoa, for the longest. If you said goodbye to me tonight, there would still be music left to write. What else could I do? I'm so inspired by you. That hasn't happened for the longest time. Once I thought my innocence was gone. Now I know that happiness goes on. That's when you found me, when you put your arms around me, and I haven't been there for the longest time. Whoa, for the longest time. Whoa, for the longest. I'm that voice you're hearing in the hall, and the greatest miracle of all is how I need you, and how you won't name it to that hasn't happened. Are they changing keys? It's just so weird. Maybe this won't last very long, but you feel so right, and I could be wrong. Maybe I've been hoping too hard, but I've gone this far, and it's more than I hoped for. Who knows how much further we'll go on. Maybe I'll be happy when you're gone. I'll take my chances. I forgot how nice romance is, and I haven't been there for the longest time. I had second thoughts at the start. I said to myself, hold on to your heart. Now I know the woman that you are. You're wonderful by far, and it's more than I'd hoped for. I don't care what consequence it brings. I have been a fool for lesser things. I want you so bad. I think you ought to know that I intend to hold you for the longest time. Andy Kaufman's here. Whoa, for the longest time. Oh, for the longest time. Whoa, for the longest time. Oh, for the longest time. Yes, he is here. Well, that was great. Billy, yeah, I'm very happy now. All right, Billy Joel once again is in for a 3-day stint, and I understand, Billy, that you will be back tomorrow with the finale of yes, that's right. It's what we've been working for. But as soon as you turn off this video, you practice that with John. This is how I work. All right. I work the same way. When I have the luxury of rehearsal, and I can really do a good job, yeah. Oh, God, remember the days of rehearsal, John? Yeah, I do. It comes back to me when I'm here with you, like this. The discipline. Discipline. You put the lin in discipline. You know that. Did I really? Yeah. And the disciple. The disciplined disciple. My best disciple. Really? Yes. Praise be God and Mother. That's nice news, right? So, how are we doing? You're doing fine. You're talking about with Andy's situation. You're doing fine. She likes. All right, because I don't want to step on toes, but I want to do my job as a disciple. Yes, you're doing perfectly. And Andy thanks you, and we all thank you. All right. Thank you. Yeah. It's all you could hope. It's all you could hope. You could have had another situation where they became like that one or the other one, the two, the Mitzi and Moffat there. You mean the twin flames of Stevie Ray and Greg Allman. I can say this, right? Yeah. I won't say their names, but these girls really, I sometimes wonder what on earth are they doing now? Like, because that's still their reality, but they don't. I mean, I don't think. Have those guys. Yeah, they're moving on. They gotta. Energy can't stagnate like that. All right. I don't want to know anymore. Why do you say it like that? Well, because we have such a good relationship, and I can't believe the way that someone would throw a relationship like that away, because essentially, that's what we are. Our relationship is what everyone's shooting for, right? Or is that vain of me to say? I could look at you talk. I don't even have to hear your voice. You know that? I could just watch your mouth all day. All right, why don't you just calm down? That's why I don't want you on camera. I don't want anyone looking at this face but me. Really? Is that true? Because if that's true, then I'm officially, yeah, you're off the hook. You don't have to be on camera unless you really want to. I want you to myself. I'm sick of channeling these guys. All right, let's show our latest piece of artwork. He doesn't mean it, guys. No, we know. Jared Leto is also here. Also, Andy Kaufman, you know you have a card coming. Double check on that, Lena. Really? Yeah. Andy Kaufman. All right, John, make a mental note. Please help me remember these cards. Yeah. And I want to say too a big hello to Cab Calloway, who's been on standby this whole week because of one William Joel. Yeah, it's all right, but I feel kind of the same way. I want you to at least perfect one or two numbers for me if you could do that. Sure. I'm gonna go in with you free and clear for rehearsal. I don't want you looking up lyrics or anything. Let's right after you practice with Billy tonight, or maybe before Bill. Yeah, you can have a first. Gee, John. Yeah, I'll see. This is when I start getting antsy. He's a little serious, but it's all right, John. Nobody's overstepping. No how, no way. Well, maybe he is a little. Billy, that was really fun doing that number. And again, Billy's card is the Knight of Wands. And that is, I'm doing work with John, and that's what we're up to right now. Cab, can we look at your card? Of course. The star. Oh, marvelous. And that's you, honey. You do according to your schedule. You do according to what you need to do for yourself. None of this undue pressure. Now show the nice art project. All right, well, we can bring Billy back for this, right? Sure. This eye immediately reminded me of our star boy, Jared Leto. And as soon as I started thinking of him, he popped in. Now, Jared, I know that's we also know him as Theodonis, right? Jared Leto is a star in many ways. He has these kind of crazy looking eyes, even though this is look like an abstract. It's going to be he kind of this is Jared right here. He's a total mystic. And I just rewatched with John his masterful performance in Requiem for a Dream. And I will say, how are you, boy? My young fellow Jared. Our boy. I want you to know right now that I don't need you to follow me on Twitter or any place else. I wouldn't be angry if you started to, really, but I feel fine coming in like this. And even though I was in about a year ago, I think, if you know. It feels like I was just here. I get what you're saying. Yeah, the telepathy is a different, it does feel like, I remember everything about that visit practically, just you're just very easygoing to talk to. And we talked about you starring in that movie, I Killed John Lennon, and you starred as Mark David Chapman, and you pulled a De Niro, a Raging Bull. You put on like 50, 60 pounds for the role of Mark David Chapman. You were unrecognizable, and your acting was nothing short of, it was so piercingly real, and you managed to make that character empathy worthy somehow. Which is astounding. And it wasn't at all, had nothing to do with you there being a cute Jared Leto under all that makeup. It had nothing to do with that. It was your acting. As a you're an astounding actor. So what I'm saying about Jared Theodonis is that he does never shies away from bizarre roles for such a good, for such a good looking guy. You could say, like, he played in the House of Gucci, he put on all that crazy prosthetic makeup as the weird looking kind of chubby brother who was not very successful in the Gucci empire. And again, I had no idea you were in that movie, and I kept saying, why do I know this actor? I know those eyes. I know the eyes. And then when it dawned on me that it was him, I was just, because I didn't think you could fool me, but you did. You didn't fool me as Chapman. I still saw you in there. But that role, that Gucci role, you're really embarrassing me, ma mother. So in Requiem for a Dream, that's an old movie. I believe it is the year 2000, but it could be older. Jared plays a young, really badly drug addicted, lower middle class kid, whose father died and whose mother, Ellen Bernstein, is like neurotic and lonely and sad, and he feels guilty about that. But and at the end, the short, long story short, the most, one of the most gruesome drug addict endings of that I'd ever seen portrayed on film. They had to amputate his arm. The arm got gangrenous. Whoa. And I remember when I first watched it, I remember being profoundly moved, but I was drinking in those days when I saw that film. And so I don't always remember a lot. I know, but I will remember that I really, if something really moved me. I did remember over the years that that movie was very powerful in my mind and very vivid. But I shied away from rewatching it, which is really not like me. It was the arm. That arm, that gangrenous arm that just kept getting worse. What a role to play. And you did, and this role to me, I feel like it is the most invaluable public service announcement against fucking yourself up with drugs that anyone could present to the world, John. Wouldn't you say so? It's that strong. You're right. Everyone should be made to watch, all the schools should be made to watch that. If they're not doing that, they should be. I don't know what they're doing in the schools anyway, but Jared, what have you to say? I like what you're doing with this so far. It's really going to be another one of those great things that you do. Yeah, I didn't know that I was going to be moving this direction, but and that's the thing about art, you know. It's so movable, it's so flexible if you do it right, and you could change this at any time. You could just, you know, and it's, I heard you thinking, oh, this thing is so small. If I don't, if I, you know, I'll just throw a whole nother coat of gold over the whole thing and start over, right? But somehow I don't think you will do that with this. But I could be wrong. But I think it's going to be a mini masterpiece. Thank you, Jared. John, Well, if I have anything to say about it, it will, right? So it's the eyeball theme, but it's going to be like a mosaic eye. And we might just, we have a lot of like gold chips and stuff. We should definitely bling it out. Absolutely. Yeah? Yeah. That's my girl. Yeah, all right. That's what we'll do. So if you haven't seen Requiem for a Dream out there, please do see it. Mm-hmm. It's a little hard to take, and I'll tell you what, John remembered exactly when this when the scenes were gonna come up that bothered me the most. And every time that happened, he like moved my head. And I wanna thank you. Yeah, you don't have to look at it. The rest of the story was amazing, and the acting, you know, it's really, yeah, it's a very small part of it, but the gruesomeness is so intense that you feel like you've been exposed to too much by the time it's over, you know, but yeah, it definitely, you would not want to be an intravenous drug user for sure. And I found that the other chilling portrayal was Ellen Burstyn from, remember with Mom from The Exorcist? Well, she played Mom in this, Brighton Beach widow, you know, and just like she, you know, just like Edith Bunker type. And she wants to lose some weight to get on a game show because she's so fucking bored out of her skull and crazy that she gets addicted to diet pills so she can lose weight and look good on television. And she just becomes a total fucking speed freak. And whoever filmed that had to know what that felt like when you were careening out of control on speed, because the camera work made me relive like some of my worst nights, right down to the grinding of her jaws. And I was terribly moved by that performance, more so than I remember being the first time I saw it. I really zoned in on the authenticity of that speed freak experience and seeing it in this older woman, you know, like, you know, we were young when we were, yeah, when we had our issues with that, John and I both. Mm-hmm. What about you, Jared? Oh, well, you dabble, you know, this is the nature of life down here. So, you know, come on, you're a positively fabulous person, very coherent, but let's face it, I did major dabbling, and I never say that I didn't. So what are you saying about me or you or what? Yes, I've tried a lot of different things, and I know when, yes, good for you. Good for you. All right, so I think we're going to wrap up. We just want to say thank you, Jared. Thank you, Andy Kaufman. I will check to make sure we're getting that card. I think you're right, yeah. I think there was a bypass and somehow we didn't pick one out. John, we don't make mistakes over here. All right. Excuse-moi. Praise be to God and Mother. Praise be to little Booba, who, look at him. Could you die from this adorableness of this moment?
Booba. Booba.
Don't wake him up. I just want him to look in the camera.
Booba.
Booba. He won't look up. But he likes it over there. He's our darling Booba. Don't you love him to death? I do. I do love him to death, Lena. Come on, we got some rehearsing to do. Right. Oh, and so then the other thing is to art. Any kind of art. It'll snap you out of it. Yeah. You know, you got to make the effort, though. Just pick up the stuff and do something, you know? Even if it's just a little thing like this. Now, I can't wait to get back to this. Yeah. Yeah, we're going to get back to it. We'll do a little bit more on this tonight, and then we got to rehearse. All right. I love you, honey. I love you, too. I love you. I love you. All right, now you have to let me do it. All right. Yeah, don't even think. Where's a heart? Where is a heart? I don't see one. Oh, there's one. Heart. Jo. I heart. Jo. All right. Thank you, honey. I love you too.